thought we would save this one up for you. Last year, we recorded the brilliant Chris Wood, and we've decided now is the time to bring it out of the vault. So whether this is a reminder of that evening, a chance to revisit that special night, or your first experience of it, you are lucky either way. We present the amazing Chris Wood.
Kids are in the back seat, tiny headphones in their ears, queuing in the fast lane for the mile. Mum and Dad are struggling, it's not been right for years, but how they love their brand new car interior smell. I've just had an hour with a financial advisor, he's a nice chap, but I'm none the wiser. Out here in our market towns with our pound shops and our bookies, the Argos catalogue is our tormentor. I saw a young lad and his mum, they almost held a hand as they went into the army recruiting centre. I've just had my monthly meet with a job club supervisor, but she signed me off, I was completely none the wiser. Someone's daughter's selling phone sex just to buy a student loan back. She does her best to emulate the sound of choking. It's not the strongest that go forward, it's the ones who can adapt. You can bet Charles Darwin wasn't joking. While in the five-star saunas of the hotel TripAdvisor, it's always business, business, business. Oh, it's always none the wiser. Finger and we laugh at Christ as he walks out on the water, and we undermine the faithful with our teasing. But in the bowels of the Bank of England now, they're sacrificing chickens to a god they call quantitative easing. To the masters of the universe, we are naught but fertilizer. What kind of beast is man? So let's have the truth, the whole truth, nothing but the truth we cry. But the sound bitten demand is oh so hollow, 'cause we are each of us subscribers until the day we die. Truth like that was way too big to swallow. So I got my repeat prescription for my favorite tranquilizer. As soon as that kicks in, I know I'll be none. Kids are in the back seat with tiny little headphones in their ears.
I'm never sure, you see, I'm never quite sure. It's
sometimes, you know, it's a kind of a way of gauging an audience, really. So, you know, when you get in the bigger cities and that, you get a bit of going on. They're going, yay! And you get out, so, you know, you get out into the sort of the, you know. It's a different sort of an audience. You know, they're sort of waiting politely for the feedback to finish. And when it finishes, they'll give a round of applause, you know. It's fine. It's all right, you know. Vive la différence, you know. It's cool. So, it's a bit like that, isn't it, you know. Friday night. We can go mental. I didn't really make any of that up. I had a while, a few years ago, I had a big tour where I was supporting Joan Armour Trading. We did 51 cities in 60 days. And what it meant was just fucking loads of hanging around, you know. And so, you know, you'd wake up in Rill or I don't know, Limerick or somewhere, you know. You'd wake up there and you'd have all day. And I just was hanging around in coffee shops and, you know, just getting a snapshot of what it was like to live in these strange times. And virtually everything that took place in that song and everything that was said in that song was, I didn't write any of it, really. I just, you know, listen, cut it up, put it in. I wrote this one when I dropped my daughter off at university. I don't know if there's any empty nesters here. They look like there's a few people who've forgotten. I'm interested. You see, the thing is, I got into folk music because I was, you know, I was sick of the Churchillian version of history. And I got into folk music because I felt like there was a kind of a, oh, that's what it was like to live during the Napoleonic Wars. Oh, that's what it was like to live in Dickensian London. And so when it was time for me to kind of give back a little bit and try and write some stuff, I just wanted to write stuff that was kind of, you know, somebody 100 years hence might go, oh, that's what it was like to live under Boris Johnson. Or whatever, you know. So I wrote this after I dropped my daughter off at university and she didn't go in the end, but she didn't tell us for a year. Yeah, how cool is that? I've never prouder of her for not going, and then, you know, she didn't tell us until she was set up. She had a flat in London, she had a decent job, you know. How cool is that? It's your very first top floor flat and all that. Your shower runs hot or too cold. Your hoover's broke and the wiring is toast. It must be 100 years old. Your mad landlady turned your waterworks on when she stole your birthday mail. Take it all on the chin, my little darling. This love won't let you fail. This love won't let you fail. There's a job at the pub next door but one. They say they need a bright young thing at the bar. Get up, little darling, put some shoes on and show them what a bright young thing you are. Cause 20-odd years ago on a misty autumn morning I knew this day would come. There's a postcard here in the window. It says, who for sale. This love won't let you fail. This love won't let you fail. Now you ride through the city at 4 a.m. You're living the life of the night. A little drunken text every now and again lets us know that you're alright. Oh, you get to bed as the sun comes up. Your mother's worried 'cause you're looking so pale. You're looking so pale. This love won't let you fail. This love won't let you fail. There's a photograph of a tired little girl. She's up on the downs with her dad and they're flying their kite. She's all grown up now, but he's still there, trying to let go with all his might. Oh, catch the wind now, darling, and run, run like hell. Over hill and over dale, you'll be a speck on the horizon before too long. This love won't let you fail. This love won't let you fail. This love won't let you fail. I ought to sing this one now. It's a song I wrote for my son. Now, until very recently, I'd written two songs for my daughter and none for my son. And he's been very big about it. That's all I can say, very big about it. And so, for his 30th birthday... I know, yeah. Sometimes I hardly know you. I've been so hopelessly self-unemployed. I wasn't there to show. show you all the stuff a son of mine might want to know, like how to be a player in the passing show. You may not get the lead, but have a go. I just know they're gonna love you. Love to hear you play that crappy old guitar. Lost in admiration. Do you have any idea of just how good you are? Years of dedication. There's always room for one more struggling troubadour. But it's like trying to rob a bank that's just been robbed before. And if you think that's a clunky metaphor, well, I got it off Randy Newman. What kind of world is this I've brought you to? I often sit and wonder, but I just know you're gonna find your own way through this spell they try and put us under. You're much smarter now than I would ever be. So my last piece of advice, stop listening to me. I started working on this song when you were three. I hope I haven't left it too late.
This is a song I got from the singing of Doc Boggs. Doc Boggs was a Kentucky miner. It's interesting trying to link songs up. You know, all sorts of different songs. And then you kind of see if the audience get the link or not. Or maybe they hear a different link. Or maybe they don't hear any link at all. So I haven't sung a proper folk song tonight. I used to sing a lot of folk songs a long time ago. And then I started kind of changing the words a bit, you know, and in the end I got to a point where there was a trad folk song and all I'd kept was the first line. I'd rewritten the rest and I suddenly thought, oh, hang on a minute, you know, you could be... So that's kind of how it happened, you know, I sort of, you know, a bit like going further and further into the deep end and, you know, then a wave lifts you off your feet and you go, ooh, whoa, hey, we're swimming here. But I'll try to get this one dead right, you know. I haven't changed any words as far as I can tell. So this is the song of Sweet Sunny South. You'll know why I'm singing it for sure.
Crystal spring to the broad flowing stream. Ever dear is my memory and sweet is my dream. I leave my confinement and comfort of life for the dangers of bloodshed, privation and strife. I have come to conclude and reply with my word, as I shouldered my musket and belted my sword. My father embraced me with anguish of heart. My mother implored me to part. My beautiful sister looked pale in her woe, as she grabbed me and blessed me and told me to go. I'm a man with a promise to keep, for the dangers of war as I soon will steer, and for sickness and death I intend to prepare. Mother, dear mother, for me do not weep, for my mother's kind voice I ever will keep. You have taught me be brave, from a boy to a man. Now I'm going in defense of our own native land. Cannot temper woe. Your tears and your sadness, they grieve my heart so. But I must away, here I cannot stand. I'm going in defense of our own native land. In the bright sunny south, in and content, the days of my boyhood I scarcely had spent. From the clear crystal spring to the broad flowing stream, ever dear is my memory and sweet is my dream.
Sing this, it's another allotment song, this one. I don't have any more allotment songs after this, you know. It's not just gonna be fucking Gardener's World, you know. It's a song about retirement, or semi-retirement, or whatever it is, you know. I was trying to get my wife to retire, to sort of semi-retire, you know, go down to sort of 3 days a week. In the song, I'm trying to get her to go down to 3 days. She went down to 4 days a week, which was pretty good. And now, you'll be pleased to hear she's completely retired now. And she's taken to it like a duck to water, I have to say. It's usually blokes, isn't it, who have struggled a bit with retirement, you know what I mean? Yeah, maybe you don't, actually, yeah. I had a mate, you know, I've got a mate who retired quite early. He was sort of head of IT at Dungeness Power Station. And then he was head of IT at Hinkley Power Station. And he took sort of quite early retirement. And honestly, within about 3 weeks, he was colour coding the cleaning products under the sink, you know. He had a spreadsheet for the bird food. It was just... took him about 3.5 years to just you know. Needless to say, there'll be no retiring for me. Retire from what? The only thing I ever loved doing. It's not in tune, but I get a bit suspicious when stuff's in tune all the time. Do you know what I mean? Fucking young people, these young folkies, they're always in tune, aren't they? They're always perfectly in tune. What is it that they don't understand about folk music, you know? It's supposed to be a little bit shit, you know? It doesn't sound right if it's completely in tune. Monday to Wednesday, it's business as usual. So what's so unusual about my sweet dear? She's altered, she's different, she's just so spectacular. She's what we got wed for, she's keen and she's clear. 'Cause Henrietta is just at the good sense, and she's wrote them a letter in which they are all advised that Henrietta has made a decision, and from this day forward, my darling's downsized. Just last Wednesday evening, she kicks off her work shoes. I pour her a large one, and I tell you no lies. She swigs and she shimmies, and she looks to the bedroom. Oh, and then she looks at me with those great big blue beautiful downsized eyes. Now the sun in the morning somehow seems brighter. Oh, and everything's brighter than it was before. The coffee is richer, the eggs are very easier, the breeze is just breezier, and there's cuddles galore. She bakes some rock cakes, I lay a fire, I light the touch paper, but I don't retire. 'Cause my love for her cannot be overstated. It's deep and it's not final salary related. 'Cause Henrietta is just at the good sense, she's wrote them a letter in which they are all advised that Henrietta has made a decision, from this day forward, my darling's downsized. The allotment society application she's made, she's put her names forward, and she's bought me a spade. And when old Father Summertime raises his head, we'll be up there to prepare our celeriac bed. I'll dig us a trench, then I'll join her in sitting,
up close on the bench and we'll watch the Spuds cheating. Then I'll pinch out some carrots, she'll squish some black flies, and then she'll look at me with those great big blue beautiful downsizers. 'Cause Henrietta is just at the good sense, and she's wrote them a letter in which they are all advised that Henrietta has made a decision, and from this day forward the love of my life, my best friend and my companion, my darling, is downsized.
A madrigal by Orlando Gibbons, who was born on Christmas Day in 1583, called The Silver Swan.
The silver swan, who living had no note, when death approached unlocked her silent throat, leaning the reedy shore, then sung her first and last, and sung no more. Farewell, all joys, O death, come close mine eyes. More geese than swans now live, more fools than wise. If ignorance is bliss, they say 'tis folly to be wise. But have you ever looked into their eyes? Try and catch their gaze. Tell me what you see, 'cause that don't look like bliss to me. It looks like frightened and uncertain, like what is going on. It looks like wherever the promise is gone. It looks like being asked to eat up something someone else begun. Oh, it looks like hurry up and get this done. If ignorance is bliss, they say 'tis folly to be wise. bait a hook for simple and watch the simple rise. Everything is simple when you are simple too. I'll let your red top do the work for you. Learn to hate your neighbor as you would hate yourself, while the dream stays wrapped in cellophane on the top shelf. If you could fog a mirror, you'd be free to leave. Oh, but you're so angry, you can't breathe. If ignorance is bliss, they say it is folly to be wise. Everything in black and white, no compromise. They say that with no power comes no responsibility. They say your ignorance will set you free. Free to dream of empire and the sun that never sets. Free to walk away from all your debts. And when the grandkids ask how were you so easily misled, feel free to bow your head. If ignorance is bliss, they say it is folly to be wise. But have you ever looked into their eyes? Try and catch their gaze. Tell me what you see. 'Cause that don't look like bliss to me.
Shall not cease from men.
gentle fight, nor shall my sword sleep in my hand until we about Jerusalem. In England's green and pleasant land. There's all the old chaps up the back where they always sit. Their heads went down as the brand new signing slipped again. He'd been jogging to and fro to virtually no acclaim. He'd made very little impression on a highly forgettable game. And under our antediluvian floodlights, both teams looked the same. But it was only a friendly. As the fullback brought the visiting striker down, they said they heard the crunch from the dump at the edge of town. We all heard the words as they fell on stony ground. It's only a friendly. They were fishing for pike on the deli in the clubhouse bar. When young Luke came in, he'd just ridden off his uncle's car again. Now Luke is a lad with a gift for devastation, and this time the young brave had crossed the central reservation. And sure enough, the police came in, they were looking for information. Oh, but it was only a friendly. 'Cause we was on our best behaviour, we were queuing up to be polite. As we all stood and we swore Luke had been at the match with us all night. We walked them back to their car and we wished them both good night. It was only a friendly. They had just scored again when she said, I ain't a bleeding pikey, but I have demeaned myself a time or two. She let out a laugh like a bowling ball, as she slid down the gentleman's toilet wall. She held young Luke in a thrall, and that's not all. Oh, but it was only a friendly. Young Luke had meant to play the gent as he went to try and catch her, but he missed. She said, you're gonna need to be quicker than that if you wanna get kissed. He said, I don't care, you're still on my to-do list. Then the tannoy voice said something about man of the match. It was a slippery little substitute absolutely no one could catch. And all around the ground the final whistle blew. And somebody shouted something we already knew. Oi, referee, it's not all. Always all about you. It was one of the old chaps up the back where they always sit.
What happened here today?
Awake, arise, you drowsy sleeper. Awake, arise, it's almost day. No time to lie, no time to slumber. No time to dream your life away. It was a gorgeous summer's morning. It was a gorgeous summer's day. His cotton jacket was all he carried as he walked out to face the day. As he was walking, he was wondering, with a little dream as a young man will. He never heard footsteps behind him by the bus stop at Tulse Hill. From his front door, they'd had him covered. They were right behind him from the start. And though the video was buggered, someone decided he looked the part. Here comes the bus, the front doors hiss. He climbs aboard and so do they. An hour swings down into his seat. It's just another working day. But there was something in the air that morning as they came down through Brixton town. They'd sealed the station without warning. Oh, there was something going down. So he journeyed on and onward. He called his friend just to explain how he would be late and not to worry. And so to Stockwell Tube they came. Now he's on their cameras, he's on their radar, he's on their crackling radios. His Oyster card is in his pocket. At 10 a.m. through the gates he goes, and down drops the moving staircase, and deeper down go the others too. And through the hourglass the sand is falling. There is nothing they can do. When the train comes in, they are right beside him. Some say three and some say four. Some said the cameras, they weren't working. As he sat down just across from the open door. If he'd have stopped, if he'd have listened, commissioner said that it was no good. He said they gave him no instruction that an innocent man could have understood. Just a Brazilian electrician, Christ only knows what he came here for. But Hollow Point was the ammunition. Yes, I turn now for some shock and awe. Thank you. Awake, arise, you drowsy sleeper. Awake, arise, it's almost day. No time to lie, no time to slumber, no time to dream your life away. It was a gorgeous summer's morning. It was a gorgeous summer's day. His cotton jacket was all he carried as he walked out to face the day.